हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू ऑल आर फाइन। एज यू नो, इन माय प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव स्टार्टेड द एमएस एक्सेल ऑफ द चैप्टर टू। वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फार्मूलाज एंड द फंक्शंस ऑफ द चैप्टर टू। व्हाट इज द फार्मूला एंड व्हाट आर द फंक्शन? फार्मूला ऑलवेज स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द इक्वल टू साइन एंड द फंक्शंस दैट आर द इनबिल्ट फंक्शन लाइक सम फंक्शन, एड फंक्शन। For doing the difference, we use the diff functions. They are the inbuilt function, and as it is, we can use it. These are known as the functions. Then we have discussed about the basic formula and the compound formula. Basic formula is just like a simple formula in which we were using the plus operator. This is B1, B2, B3, B4. We are using only one operator when we are doing the calculations, and compound formula when we are doing more than one operator. Like we have found out the simple interest, that is principal rate, interest principal multiplied by rate multiplied by time divided by 100. In this we are using the more than two operators, that is multiply operator and the division operator. That was the compound formula. And the third thing, we have discussed the formula on the text. We have used the ampersand sign. Ampersand sign was used on the text value. As we have written the A, in A1 we have written anil, and in B we have written kips. In C we are A1 ampersand B1. Then we got the answer anil kips together in a cell C1. So this was, we were discussed in our previous session. In our today's sessions we will move further. Come to the page number 18 of your book. In this we will talk about the cell range. What is the cell range? How we can select a range, and how we can give a name to a range. Next, how we can use that name range. So firstly, what is the cell range? I will told you, as we have selected 6 Hindi marks. This is a dummy worksheet which I have made. In this I have taken the 4 columns. First is roll number, second is name, third is English, and fourth is Hindi. In this I want the sum of all the Hindi marks. I want the total of all the Hindi marks of the 5 students. Then we have to apply the sum function. We can apply the sum function here and plus, and another way is we can use a simple formula with equal to is equal to. Then we can write D2 plus D3 plus D4 plus D5 plus D6. Then we will press answer. These are the both ways by which we can find out the answers of the Hindi. Now I'm selecting this range. Like this. I have selected 68 to 174. Now I want the sum of the answer of this. I'm coming here. This I am applying the equal to sign. Then I am writing the SUM sum function, inbuilt function, and apply the and started the bracket, and then I am applying this range here. Sorry. Now you can see, as I have, after applying the bracket, as I have selected the range, that is 68 to 174, and the name of this cell is D2 to D6. Automatically, as I selected, it is written here, that is D2 to D6. So this is the range I told you earlier, how we can give a range. Agar different cells, I can also give the name of the different cell like D2 plus D3 plus D4 plus D5 plus D6. Else I can write down like a range, that D2 colon then D6. This is the range from D2 to D6. Now I am closing the bracket by applying the shift key and I am pressing the enter. Then you will get the total of these marks. That is 664 is coming here. I have selected this cell. I'm increasing their font size by going here like this, increase font size. Now you can see this is here. If you want to increase the cell width, then move it here. This. Now you can see how we can apply the range. Firstly, how we can select a range, and next how we can use that range. Now your next topic on your page is, that is using a range in a formula, which we have already used. हमने इस range को use कर लिया formula में. Our next topic is naming our range. How we can name our range. And now I am giving a name to our range. For this, what you have to go? Firstly, you have to go on this formula tab. When you click on this formula tab, you can say one group is there that is coming, that is defined name. Is it shown to you? There, this one. This is defined name. Now here, a button is here that is define name. Go there and click on this define name. As I click on this, a dialog box is appeared. That is new name. So I am giving a name to our range. मैं हिंदी के मार्क्स ही लूंगी रेंज में, and I am giving a proper name to this range. So I have used a name S1. So I have given a name S1 to this range. Now next is scope. Scope means इसका क्या स्कोप है, कहाँ तक आप इस रेंज के नेम को यूज कर सकते हैं. I have given workbook. तो workbook में जितनी भी sheets है, sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3, you can use this name in all the 3 sheets. And if you have chosen only sheet 1, then only you can use that name only sheet 1. If you choose sheet 2, then you can use this name only in sheet 2. Next is sheet 3, then you can choose this name only, you can use this name only sheet 3. But if you have chosen the workbook, then you can use this range name in all the 3 sheets, sheet 1, sheet 2 and sheet 3. Now I am using workbook. मैं कहीं भी इसको use कर सकती हूँ. If you want to give some comments to this, you can give here. If you don't, that is not a compulsory, you can skip this point also and refers to. Refers to मतलब आपने ये range कौन सी sheet के अंदर बनाई है. See here, just click sheet 1, sheet 2 and sheet 3. My sheet 3 is opened. So refer to कौन सी है, sheet 3. और मैं कौन से सेल में थी, at present E9. मैं अपनी रेंज सेलेक्ट कर लेती हूँ. As I selected my range, it will be come here. So I am moving this dialog box here. Sorry, again we have to do this. Define name, workbook, and define name. Why it is becoming so? Just wait a minute, I'm solving it. Just see there again, name I am giving S1, and scope I have given workbook. And I have selected the range from here. Now see, firstly you have to select the range. Sorry, I didn't told you. Firstly, you have to select the range. I have selected the range of the Hindi mark 68 to 174. That cell was D2 to D6, and you can see in this new name dialog box, define name dialog box, name I have given S1, its scope is in the workbook, and refer to कौन सी sheet में है, ये sheet 3 में use कर रही हूँ, और range क्या है, D2 to D6. Now the name of this range is S1. Now you can click on it, okay. That is not valid. The name should not begin with a letter or an underscore. Okay, इसके अंदर हम एक अंडर स्कोर दे देते हैं, S underscore 12. I have given a name. Now I am pressing on OK. Now this name is given. And now I will use this name. How we can, your next topic is how you can use a name range. How we can use this named range. Again, I am clicking on this cell. I am giving is equal to. I am using the sum function. Then bracket started. What was the name of my range? That was s underscore 12. Then I am writing the name of that range. S underscore 12. Now I am closing the bracket and press enter. You can see the answer. That is also a 664. यहाँ इस cell के अंदर जो ये D8 cell था इसमें मैंने range name लिखा था sum function के अंदर D2 to D6 और ये F6 वाले cell के अंदर मैंने function range का जो name दिया था S underscore 12 यहाँ मैंने वो use किया है. So this is all about how you can give a range to the cell and how you can use, how you can select a range, how you can give a name to the cell and how you can use that range name. I think these topics are clear to you and how you can use the basic formula and how you can use the compound formula. That these topics are clear to you. Now students, all these topics are clear to you and your next topic is cell references. I am not starting this topic today because if I will start it, it is a lengthy topic. It will take a more time and I have to leave it in midst. Or agar maine beech mein chhod diya, to next time when I will start it, then again I have to start this topic. So I am not moving further. So up to this, I am giving you one activity which you will have to done on the Excel sheet, and you can give me a pic of that Excel sheet on my WhatsApp number if you are listening this. Then what you have to told, this is on the page number 28 in your book. There is a some project work is given. I am showing you here in my video. See this. This project work is given here. Create a worksheet in which you maintain your monthly expenses on stationery. आपको stationery पे जो भी आपके monthly expenses होते हैं वो आपको maintain करने हैं. आपने एक Excel sheet बनानी है जिसमें main column heading आपने क्या देनी है, serial number, जितने भी items आपने stationery से buy की, next आपने commodity जो भी आपने ली, next उसका price क्या था और उसकी quantity क्या थी. ठीक है, मान लो आपने फर्स्ट सीरियल नंबर आपने लिया पेंसिल बॉक्स, एक पेंसिल बॉक्स का प्राइस क्या था आपका 25 रुपीज़. देन क्वांटिटी क्या थी उसकी, आपने 3 पेंसिल बॉक्स लिए, देन आपको टोटल निकालना है फॉर ईच हेडिंग बाय यूजिंग फार्मूला लर्न इन दिस चैप्टर. टोटल में आप क्या निकालोगे, हाउ यू विल फाइंड आउट द टोटल. फर्स्टली द टोटल ऑफ द पेंसिल बॉक्स इज प्राइस मल्टीप्लाई में क्वांटिटी. तो इसमें आप कौन सा फंक्शन यूज़ करोगे, मल्टीप्लाई का फंक्शन यूज़ करोगे, MUL. जैसे मैंने आपको सम फंक्शन बताया है SUM, ऐसे ही मल्टीप्लाई का फंक्शन है MUL. देन द ब्रैकेट विल बी स्टार्टेड, देन योर सेल नंबर ऑफ द प्राइस एंड द क्वांटिटी, एंड इन बिटवीन यू विल यूज़ अ साइन, मल्टीप्लाई साइन. मल्टीप्लाई साइन इज स्टार साइन. That is given on the on your keyboard at number 8. Number 8 पर जो star का sign है वही multiply का sign होगा. तो इस तरह आपको हर item का पहले total निकालना है and at last you have to find the total expensive by adding all the totals of all the quantities. So this is your project work, this is your activity which I am giving to you and you have to find out. मैं एक बार मल्टीप्लाई फंक्शन आपको यूज करके दिखा रही हूँ, हाउ यू विल यूज द मल्टीप्लाई फंक्शन. जस्ट कम बैक हियर. इफ यू वांट टू यूज द मल्टीप्लाई फंक्शन, हाउ यू विल यूज, क्लिक हियर, इज इक्वल टू दिस, देन MUL, ब्रैकेट स्टार्टेड. सपोज आई एम मल्टीप्लाइंग द सेल C2 मल्टीप्लाई में D2, देन आई एम राइटिंग हियर C2 देन मल्टीप्लाई साइन शिफ्ट को दबाओ और कीबोर्ड पे 8 को प्रेस कर दो। स्टार का साइन आपको दिख गया, दिस इज दिस स्टार साइन। सी टू मल्टीप्लाई में डी टू, डी टू देन ब्रैकेट क्लोज एंड देन प्रेस एंटर। सॉरी इट इज नॉट कमिंग हियर, समथिंग रॉन्ग। सॉरी दैट मल्टीप्लाई फंक्शन इज नॉट कमिंग इन माई पी सी, यू कैन चेक इन योर पी सी इफ इट इज कमिंग और नॉट। नाउ वी विल डू द सिंपल मल्टीप्लीकेशन विदाउट यूजिंग द इन बिल्ड फंक्शन। क्लिक फार्मूला ऑलवेज स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द इक्वल टू साइन। इफ यू वॉन्ट टू मल्टीप्लाई द सी टू मल्टीप्लाई माई डी टू, देन आफ्टर दैट आई विल राइट डाउन सी टू, देन आई यूज द साइन ऑफ दैट स्टार। सी टू मल्टीप्लाई में, सॉरी सी टू मल्टीप्लाई में डी टू and then I am pressing the enter and you can see here it is multiplied by C2 multiply D2. So by this you have to do this activity and you have to send me the your worksheet. You can send me the screenshot of this page, yeah, by clicking this on your mobile you can send me the answer of this worksheet. First you will surely make this worksheet. This is your assignment I am giving to you. And I think these concepts are clear to you, how we can use this, how we can make this worksheet of total expenses. Still, if you are facing any problem, you can contact me anytime on my WhatsApp number. Thank you and have a nice day, my dear students. Goodbye. Goodbye.